Active characters are what drive the story. No matter how big or small their want is from page one of the script. In 2021, the Writers Guild of America placed Hell or High Water on the 101 greatest screenplays of the 21st century so far at number 64. This is Scriptmate, and in this video, I'll be taking a look at the screenplay for Hell or High Water. Exposition in action. In the opening scene, the bank teller Elsie questions the two main characters.
Y'all are new at this, I'm guessing.
Where's the money?
I told you, it's in the safe.
Well, who has the code?
Mr. Clausen. He'll be here soon, and I suggest you fellas don't be. All you're guilty of right now is being stupid.
This indicates that they are in no way experienced with robbing banks, and we didn't need to see them plan out the robbery.
You got a gun on you, old man?
When the opening action sequence is done, keep the protagonist active. After the two opening bank robberies, the film continues with Toby and Tanner discussing what they need out of the bank robberies.
Should we leave a will? Yeah. Am I in it?
Will don't matter. She left everything to me. By Friday, it all goes to my boys.
You got any idea how much I owe Debbie in child support?
What it means if they don't get away with it, and why now? Amidst doing this, backstory is generated both with Toby and Tanner.
Yeah, well, while you were busy in jail, I was busy looking after Mama, so you can go f*** yourself.
As well as the police officers, Marcus and Parker, who we meet to show the heat is on for the bank robberies.
You may get to have some fun before they send you off to the rocking chair yet.
Meaning it hits the important storytelling keys of goals, stakes, and urgency. Use your protagonist's home to tell us about them. When we first see Toby's ranch, it's in the middle of a very rural area. It has an old windmill, and inside the house is a bedroom with a hospice bed in the middle of it. Soon after, we see Tanner's trailer. On the wall is a framed photo of Toby and Tanner as kids, indicating that Tanner has always cared for Toby. Put the protagonist at the end of their rope. We feel for Toby early on, as the bankers put him behind on a mortgage for the property of his mother's ranch.
To see you boys pay those bastards back with their own money? Well, if that ain't Texan, I don't know what is.
Without this, there is no reason for us to want Toby and Tanner to get away with the bank robberies.
Everybody get a f***ing down!
Set up and payoff. In the scene where Marcus and Parker are on their way to their third bank robbery being committed by Toby and Tanner.
Who knows? Maybe one of these bank robbers is going to want a gunfight and I can dodge my retirement in a blaze of glory.
Well, I've seen you shoot. Won't be much glory in it.
Marcus is a somewhat racist man who throughout the film makes jokes to Parker about his Native American heritage.
Well, I'm gonna get to that when I'm through the Indian insults.
Which means we like him a lot more in the climax, after Parker gets shot at and Marcus avenges him.
Yo, let me take the shot. Hell, it's my gun.
Dog on your life. He's mine.
We also don't see him shoot until that scene, which gives it such a big build-up. Add juice to a dull scene. In the scene where Marcus and Parker are at a T-Bone cafe, watching over a bank, an elderly waitress approaches them and, rather than the usual, asks,
"So what don't you want?"
and goes on to say,
"Oh, well, I think I just,
You know, I've been working here for 44 years. Ain't nobody ever ordered nothing but T-Bone steak and a baked potato. except this one asshole from New York tried to order trout back in 1987. We don't sell no goddamn trout. T-bone steaks. So either you don't want the corn on the cob, or you don't want the green beans. So what don't you want?
Which gives the scene a lot more irony than just the same old cafe scene.
One restaurant with a rattlesnake for a waitress.
When the protagonist is in a bad situation, worsen it. As we see in almost every heist movie, authority shows up to take down the bank robbers. In the climax scene, where Toby and Tanner are robbing a bank, it's bad enough to have authority show up. But they also get blood on their hands as Tanner takes out an armed security guard and an armed customer. Tanner must face off with many officers and armed civilians. While Toby must deal with four sheriffs blocking the road who need to question him.
You got your license on you?
Yes, I do.
Show not tell. In the scene where Tanner gives up and wants Toby to get away with the money, it is stated.
Let's go. Get to the casino, change the money like we planned.
This is your plan. And it worked. Every step of the way. Trust it. Where are you headed? Don't be stupid.
I love you, Toby.
Mean it.
I love you too.
By Tanner not replying to the question of where he is going, it indicates that he is on his way to taking on the law. If it were anything else, he would tell Toby that he's going somewhere which is not part of the plan. The year after its release, 2016, it was nominated at the Oscars for Best Original Screenplay, but lost to Manchester by the Sea. It appears on many letterboxed lists, which praises the film. And Hell or High Water is also my personal favourite film of the 2010s.
It's gonna haunt you, son, for the rest of your days.
Thank you for checking out the channel. Please like, subscribe, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Scriptmate, fade out.